What is up, everybody? This is Camfly64 here, bringing you guys another Minecraft episode. So I'm gonna stop talking, and I'll show you what I did. Okay, as you can see, I made a little scoreboard that showed the time, and it took me about 9 seconds to complete this map. So there we go, I stopped the clock, everything's good. So I had Baseball Bob help me with this little project that I made. You can say hello.
Hi.
Instead of being a little creeper. But so I pretty much used the whole idea of using the scoreboard system to show time. Instead of, I see a whole bunch of Minecrafters on YouTube, they have to time it on, like, try to edit perfectly during their video the time, and I think that would be a pain in the butt for me. So
no one should go through the suffering.
Yes. We totally agree. So anyway, I will show you guys we will show you guys how to build this entire little setup. Okay, now it's time for me to show you how to build the fancy contraption. So first, you want to set up the scoreboard, set up the name, and then the display, first of all. So what you need is, you want to start off with placing a block, a hopper, destroy this block, and then place a hopper so they connect to each other, like that. And then you're going to toss the sandstone in there, so it goes back and forth between them. And then you want to place a comparator, a redstone signal. There we go. Since the signal is solid, you're okay. We don't need to do all that other fancy stuff. So now we can just build the signal. I want to break it off right here. And then we can go two separate ways. This is where we're going to start working on the command blocks. So 137, 1. Now I got a command block. Place two of them. First command you want to type is score board objectives add. We'll set this one as this is like the this name right that I'm talking right here, or timers, that's right there. That's what all the other command blocks would recognize it by, so you want that one to be specific. And then this is like a type. We're gonna do death count. Make sure the C is capitalized. I tried using the dummy, and it did not work out too well, so I'm just using death count. You don't actually have to die, but anyway. So, and now it's time to add the display name. We'll just set this as timers. It doesn't really matter, but okay. Set this one. For this one, this is the display one. I'm gonna do backslash score board objectives set display, and then there's like three different displays just below. I forgot, like, there's like below and sidebar, that's all I know. We're just gonna do sidebar for this purpose because it's a little bit nicer. And then we're gonna name it timers. Boom. Now we can just complete this little circuit right here, and it is set. So perfect. Now it's time to actually build the real thing. So let's just take the hopper out of our inventory and the comparator. So now we want to grab some levers, any block of your choice, as long as it doesn't, you know, receive a redstone signal. And you need a sticky piston. And I think that's about it. Probably wrong, but go over here and build this wall. Just like a small little wall so you can just place your little levers. And on the other side, you want to have don't want that to happen. You want to place two blocks between the start and the stop, and then you don't necessarily need it for the reset button. For the reset button, it's going straight into the signal is going straight into the command block. So first, when you want to start, you could either use like a button or, as you saw in the video, the tripwire to use this. So for the start, go over here, dig a hole, I think I'm doing this correctly, and have this connect over like that. And then you'll have 1, 2, 3 redstone or repeaters, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 redstone repeaters. So this kind of makes it like a little repeating system. And then I leave these ones at 0 ticks or 1 tick or whatever it's called, and then I leave these ones at this one at 3, this one at 4, and this one at 4. Place redstone. Now it's all connected. Then go over here and then hook it up into the command block. That would add. This adds time, so every time it goes around 1 second, it adds another second to the board. So every time it goes through, you get another one, another one, another one. So before I enter in the command for it, let's do the other thing. So now for the stop time, you want to go out a little bit. Don't worry about that right now. And then you want to place a piston block of your choice to cut off the signal once you're done. And then wrap it around over here. Place a redstone repeater into the back of it. So like when I flip this, that'll go over and then stop it. So let's test this out. That seems like it's about a second or so. And then if you want to stop it, flip this block. There we go. It stopped. And just for proof, I'll flip it again to look at it. Flip it back up. It's still going. And flip this lever. I'll let the signal go through. There we go. Perfect. Now we got that set up. Now it's time to add some values to these blocks or commands. This one, you want to type in /score. Board objectives, or no, I'm not objectives, I mean players add, and then you want to do and that's timers, which is the thing you originally named it before, then one, so it adds 1 point every single time it gets a redstone signal. So we got that. That's build like the reset time. So it's /scoreboard players and a timers 0. Or no. Set a timer 0. So now we want to start the clock. Boom. I got 1 point, 1 second, 2 second, 3, 4. It's a little bit slow, so let's speed this up. 8. That's about it. 12, 13, 14, 15. Let's turn that one to 2. 20, 21. Yeah, that's about it. And then if you want to stop the signal, flip it. Stopped, and then we go into reset, and there we go. So that's pretty much how to build your own little clock system in your map. I would highly recommend this if you want to build like a race map when you want players competing to compete against each other. This does work with every single player, so let's say you got like 2 or 3 more people in it, and you like start the clock. I broke it. That's an issue. You don't want to keep this on for too long. That's why you want to have a button or a tripwire. So, there, we have the signal going. It's going to add time to every single player, so it's always going to be the same. And, yeah, hopefully this tutorial helped you guys. And reset the time. Uh-oh. I didn't stop it properly. You got to stop it, wait for the signal to go all the way through. Reset time. And, hopefully this is a helpful tutorial for you guys. Please don't forget to like, rate, and comment. And subscribe if you want to get some more map making helpful tutorials for your map to make maps a whole lot better. So, thank you guys for watching and have a nice day.